airport in the national airspace system has unique and distinct characteristics, which can sometimes lead pilots to use the wrong surface in taxi, takeoff, or landing operations. Let's take a look at some of these tricky areas. From the flight deck. John Wayne, Orange County is a busy, medium-sized, multi-use airport located in the city of Santa Ana, California. It has a Class Charlie airspace that partially underlies the Los Angeles Class Bravo. Pilots flying into the busy Southern California airspace need to be completely familiar with rules and requirements to operate in this complex environment. The airport layout consists of two closely spaced parallel runways with staggered thresholds, labeled runway 2 left and right and 20 left and right. The vast majority of the time, SNA is in the south configuration utilizing runways 20 left and right. The taxiway system provides access to all ramps, service, and FBOs located on either side of the runways. Several flight schools are located at the airport. The traffic mix consists of everything from primary trainer large cabin class corporate jets up through large transport category aircraft. The mix of pilot experience and aircraft capability makes John Wayne Orange County Airport a challenging place to fly. As with any airport with this runway configuration, the risk of wrong surface operations exists. Special attention needs to be paid to runway taxiway clearance at all times to avoid a potentially costly error. As always, if you are ever in doubt or don't understand an instruction or clearance, the easiest answer is to ask the tower. Controllers would much rather spend an extra transmission or two to ensure proper compliance rather than have an incident or accident. In addition, aircraft landing runway 20 left should use caution due to jet blast from aircraft holding between runways 20 left and 20 right at Taxiway Lima. Aircraft holding short of runway 20 right at Taxiway Lima need to be fully pulled up to the hold bars, as this ensures clearance from the runway 20 left runway safety area. When arriving at SNA for the first time, there are a couple of items that will make your approach and landing easier. Familiarity with VFR reporting points will help controllers sequence you. If you are not familiar or can't locate these points, advise the controller so they can issue alternate instructions. When approaching from the north or northwest, you may be instructed to cross midfield at an altitude above pattern altitude to enter the downwind for the smaller runway. After crossing the airport, you may descend to pattern altitude. There are specific pattern instructions for aircraft arriving and departing runway 2 right, 20 left. When departing runway 20 left, start a 15-degree left offset at the departure end of the runway to avoid traffic departing the larger runway 20 right. VFR aircraft departing runway 2 right should offset 15 degrees right at the departure end of the runway. This offset also applies to arriving aircraft. Here, the aircraft is on approach to runway 20 left and is offset so as to avoid conflicting with traffic inbound for runway 20 right. Never make a straight-out departure from runway 2 right, 20 left, unless specifically instructed to do so by the tower. Detailed information concerning this procedure, including offset and altitude requirements, are in the chart supplement and should be completely understood by pilots. Aircraft inbound to runway 20 left from the southeast with a VFR pattern entry are to be directly over or just slightly right of UC Irvine for a proper pattern entry to runway 20 left. Aircraft are frequently aiming for the midfield of the airport as opposed to the midfield of runway 20 left for their 45-degree pattern entry. This creates a head-on conflict with VFR Newport departures. Hotspot number one is located at the intersection of taxiways Alpha and Lima. It primarily concerns air carrier traffic, but GA pilots need to be aware. ATC will advise aircraft when to turn from Alpha onto Lima and hold short of runway 20 left. Pilots have crossed the hold short line for runway 20 left without authorization. Hotspot number two concerns aircraft exiting runway 20 right or left and instructed to hold short of the other runway. The distance between runways makes the available holding space limited. Pilots need to ensure that they are clear of the runway behind them, but must hold short of the runway ahead. Hotspot number three has to do with the aircraft cleared runway 20 left or right, taxi via Alpha, Hotel, Charlie. Pilots have missed the turn onto Charlie and entered runway 2 right, 20 left. Complete understanding of taxi clearance, including route, turns, and hold short instructions before you begin to taxi, will go a long way in avoiding this error. When departing SNA, remember that a clearance is required for both VFR and IFR flights to operate in the John Wayne Class Charlie airspace. After obtaining your clearance, ground control will direct you to one of several run-up areas around the field. When your run-up is complete, contact ground control for clearance to continue taxi. Two more areas of which transient pilots need to be aware. First, there is a robust helicopter operation at the field. The primary landing areas for helicopters are found at various points along taxiways Alpha and Bravo. Second, any time light general aviation aircraft operate in the same area as large or heavy air carrier aircraft, special attention must be paid to wake turbulence avoidance, both on the ground and in the air. Being aware of the hotspots and other configuration issues at SNA will help pilots make better decisions and, along with the ATC tower, keep the operation safe and efficient. We hope this short video helps you prepare for your trip to the John Wayne Orange County Airport. It's always better to know before you go.